we're going to be tracking. This is a massive storm system. The other problem, with all due respect to the lady sitting to my left, is an anchor. It's going to weigh things down.
That's what we do.
That's exactly what you guys do. It's just going to make it move through slower. That's all I mean by that, Laura. It's the current temperature outside. Pretty nice. 70 degrees, 71% humidity with a gust of 28 miles an hour. Otherwise, your south winds are blowing in at 21. Very mild across the area. 70s all across the region. Way above average. That's the other thing that should get your attention. Already coordination among the meteorologists at the National Weather Service in Pleasant Hill and out toward Topeka, even down toward Springfield, making sure that you know that the thing that we're most concerned about with this slow-moving system is flooding. We're going to pick up quite a bit of heavy rain before this thing is out of our region, and it's going to take at least a couple of days before it even gets to that point. Here it is on clouds and radar. We have the clouds moving in. A couple folks have already called up saying that the clouds are thickening up. Still pretty warm. If you do have evening plans, I think you're going to be fine. We're looking farther to the south. That's where we start to see some of the showers and thunderstorms forming in lines. And down toward Oklahoma, Texas, and western Texas, especially out there, see how there's a gap in between these individual thunderstorms? That's what we call supercells. These are the ones that we have to really be concerned about for that region to get tornadoes. For us, I don't think we're going to be on that side of the coin necessarily. For the next 4 hours, strong winds, as you saw, gusts up to 28, up to 30 miles per hour on occasion. Those clouds will continue to gather in. Rain will be moving in later on tonight. And I say rain, also a couple thunderstorms as well. And there you can see just now peering through Arizona going toward New Mexico, as we showed you in that video. That's where the storm system is. Powerful thing that's continuing to move its way from the Four Corners region, already ejecting some pretty heavy amounts of rain through New Mexico and also southern portions of Colorado. Once this thing taps into the moisture already in place from the Gulf of Mexico, that's when we're going to see explosive thunderstorms, especially over the western high plains. I guarantee you're going to be reading about quite a few headlines as far as tornadic weather. And this is the bullseye for that on Monday. Probably the Red River Valley, Oklahoma, Arkansas, Louisiana. As you go farther to the north, I'm thinking more damaging winds and damaging hail, and we're still targeted for that. So be on the lookout for that. Late morning, especially to the west. Early afternoon to early evening over Kansas City. It should, at least the tornadic, or correction, the severe thunderstorm threat should be out of here in fairly short order. On future scan, though, we are still going to look for cloudy skies to continue to thicken up. Chances of rain will be increasing. I still think there's an outside chance of a couple of stray showers by 10 in the morning. But look at what happens. This will be the big show that could give us that damaging wind, damaging hail possibility. It should be out of here by, say, midnight or so. Then we have to wait for another wave of heavier rain to move through. This is by Tuesday morning at 7. So we're going to be in and out of some thick rain. The first one's the only one we have to be concerned about as far as the damaging winds or damaging hail threat. After that, it's just going to be rainstorm after rainstorm after rainstorm. That's when we shift to flooding. Look at the high temperatures, 71 degrees. Best chances with the red lights from noon to about 9 p.m. And more rain will be coming through overnight into Tuesday as well. As far as amounts are concerned, before it's all said and done, by Wednesday, we could see 1 to 3 inches of rain. That's really going to start to make ponding on roads pretty commonplace all across the area. This is your 7-day forecast. 71 degrees on Monday, 61 on Tuesday. Wednesday still has a chance of some rain, 60 degrees then. By Thursday, any leftovers. Friday dries out, paving the way for a fairly nice weekend. Morning temperatures cool down, and they may even go colder than that, depending on how much colder air the system decides to yank down from the north. But because it's strong enough to produce that snow in Arizona, I may be a little optimistic for that. You see 63 on Thursday, 66 degrees on your Friday, and the pop chart, probabilities of precipitation, 100% chance coming in tomorrow, 80% chance on Tuesday, 70% chance on Wednesday. So if you're trying to do something outside, like either landscaping or lawn, probably not the first.